Morning. My decision to run alongside Valerie was to show black and brown voters, first-time voters, no-time voters, the LGBTQ community, women, especially women of color, and all underrepresented and disenfranchised groups that we have the power to make the decisions for our state. I know that when these groups are involved and engaged in decision-making, they have the ability to affect real change. And it is change what we need in 2018. Right now, it is perfectly legal to discriminate against felons in nearly all of the ways that it was once legal to discriminate against African Americans. By stripping them of their right to vote, denying education, housing and employment, denying food stamps and other public services, suddenly discrimination is legal again. As Michelle Alexander stated, today as a criminal, you have scarcely more rights and arguably less respect than as a black man living in Alabama in the height of Jim Crow. Rushern and Valerie, Elizabeth and I, we know that we need a government that serves every neighborhood across this great state. I know that voters need to elect people who are willing to address desegregating our schools, implement use of force laws, assess the school-to-prison pipeline, acknowledge poverty by design, and pass humane immigration reform. The people you elect to office have to be bold, fearless, and strategic. So, amidst the great sadness of the loss of my friend and my county executive, Kevin Kamenetz, I was given the great privilege to work alongside Valerie Ervin. Valerie is an advocate for all students. She is a trailblazer and a policymaker who has dedicated her life's work to creating a better future for all and to showing people that there is a way to change your story. Right now, I know that if you are involved in the solution, you are more likely to stick around to see if that solution works out. That's why I've chosen to stick around and stay involved. So to all those who have supported me, specifically my family, mi familia, mijos, Antoine, Nevea, Nalani, and Nailia, te amo mucho, muchísimas gracias. And to all of those who have supported the Ervin Johnson ticket. Yes, the Ervin Johnson ticket, it sounds like magic. So let's keep that magic and that momentum going. Now I have the pleasure of introducing my running mate and my friend, Valerie Ervin.
Thank you, Marisol.
There's a lot of stuff in the way here. Let me move some of it over. Good morning. Marisol Johnson and I filed our candidacy for governor and lieutenant governor on May 17th, less than 1 month ago. In that short period of time, we generated a growing base of support and enthusiasm among women, young people, immigrants, and people of color. Our message was a simple one that was absent in the gubernatorial race, and it resonated with this important base of voters in the Democratic primary. It came from a belief in a future that not only includes them, but a future that builds upon the incredible diversity that we all know makes Maryland great. I had 5 business days, according to state law, to decide whether I would run for governor and choose a running mate. The best call that I made was to Marisol Johnson to ask that she run for lieutenant governor on my ticket. She said yes without hesitation. Marisol is a first-generation immigrant who was born in El Salvador. Her story is the story of so many of our friends and neighbors here in Maryland and across the country. She is a mom to 4 children, runs her own successful business, and was the first Latina to win a seat on the Baltimore County Board of Education. But more than that, Marisol is young, smart, talented, and committed to a vision of Maryland that is inclusive and forward-thinking. She will be a leader to watch. Kevin Kamenetz chose me to be his running mate, and I am forever honored to have been asked to run and forever proud that I said yes. Kevin was a great man who loved his family first, his beloved Baltimore County second, where he was born and raised and went on to serve in elected office for 24 years. And finally, he loved public service and was able to accomplish amazing things for the residents of Baltimore County and the entire state of Maryland. Like Kevin, Marisol and I both believe that Maryland can have the best public schools in the nation, that college can be debt-free, that Maryland can lead the way to a 100% renewable energy portfolio, that we can create 21st century jobs, partnering with communities across Maryland to create a business ecosystem that is the envy of the nation. Unfortunately, for Marisol and I, our unlikely journey was fraught with roadblocks, the biggest being the fight to have our names on the ballot, which is a matter of voting rights. And we weren't the only ones to legally challenge the ballot. There were two other suits filed, and these legal challenges leave the outcome of this election vulnerable to being contested. We can and must do better to protect our democratic process. Change needs to happen at the legislative level and in the courts to fix Maryland's problems at the Board of Elections. We need to stand up for voting rights in Maryland. Marisol and I know that this election is bigger than the two of us. And while the roadblocks put before us have caused us to suspend our run, our vision for Maryland, Kevin's vision for Maryland, moves forward. Kevin passed the baton to me to make sure that our plans for Maryland would succeed. And today, I pass that baton on to Prince George's County Executive Rushern Baker and his running mate, Elizabeth Embry, and endorse their candidacy for governor. We did not take this or make this decision lightly. We do this because we know that this is the ticket for Maryland. This is the ticket with the experience that will lead on day one. This is the ticket that will beat Larry Hogan in November. We wholeheartedly believe that Maryland can be a beacon of hope for a nation during these troubled times. We can have the future we want, and now is the time to fight for it. We are glad to be here today to usher in a new era for the Democratic Party and a time to realize the true potential of our great state. Thank you.
Good morning. I am so proud today to stand here with Valerie Ervin and Marisol Johnson to announce that they are joining our team. As powerful women, as accomplished elected officials, and most importantly, as passionate advocates for those who have too long had no seat at the table, as they talked about, for working families, for immigrants, for the LGBTQ community, for students, and also for those who are returning from prison, these two amazing women have been fighting for their entire careers to make sure that those issues are heard. Rushern and I are so honored to have their support. And I want to be absolutely clear, today is not an ending. Today is a joining. It is a joining of forces to continue the fight for working families across the state of Maryland. As our race gets tougher, our team grows stronger. Valerie and Marisol are committed, dedicated, prepared, and will be in the fight tomorrow just like they were yesterday. When we come together, we are stronger. When we come together, our voices carry further. When we come together, we are unstoppable. And when you look at Rushern Baker, when you look at Valerie Ervin, you see people who have strong track records of delivering results for working families. Not just rhetoric, they've done the work, they've delivered the outcomes. And there is now a very clear choice in this race, as there has been from day one. A person who has led a government of nearly a million Marylanders, who's delivered jobs, who's expanded health care, who's cut crime in half, who's been a leader in the environment, who understands and has fought for transportation. And that is Rushern Baker, our next governor for the state of Maryland.
Thank you, Elizabeth. This is indeed a great day for Maryland. I am so pleased to be joined here today with this partnership, the Ervin Johnson ticket. I do like that. That is magic. Because we have two, Elizabeth and I are joined by two very accomplished women who have fought their entire lives to make Maryland better. Not just talking about it, but actually doing it in elective office at the school board where they both started their careers. Going on to the county council where Valerie and I got to know each other during troubled times in the budget, which is why I'm so glad that County Executive Ike Leggett is here with us. And then during this campaign, everyone has to admit that, you know, it started to tick up when Valerie showed up. It made the debates more interesting when Marisol showed up, because they put out front the issues that affect Marylanders every day. But the difference between their progressive agenda and our opponents is that they've actually done the work. They haven't just talked about it. When Valerie talks about providing health care for all Marylanders, she's done it at the ground level as a county council member, as a president of the county council board, for working in Montgomery County to make sure there's access to quality health care. When we talk about education, improving public education, it's not some dissertation from afar. Marisol was right there in the thick of it in Baltimore County, making sure that we improve lives for our students. So the difference between this progressive ticket that we're teaming up with and our opponent is, Valerie's actually had to deal with a budget. So during the debate, she and I would talk about the fact that we'd hear these ideas that are thrown around, and we said, well, where do you get the money for that? How do you pay for that? What things are you willing to cut? Because we both had to do it. But if you look at our counties, look at all of our counties, if you look at Prince George's County's growth, you look at Montgomery County's growth, when Valerie was working there with Ike, you look at Marisol's in Baltimore County, what we have in common are getting the job done. And so this team today, as Elizabeth said, is not about a closing. This is a coming together. This is not just the team for the election for the next 13 days. This is about taking on and beating Larry Hogan, but more importantly, providing the opportunities to all Marylanders in once we come into government. So I look forward, and we talked about this, not just having their help during the campaign, but having their help in a Baker-Emery administration to make Maryland better for everybody. I am so pleased to be standing here. It is a great, and let me just do this, it's great to be standing right here where the purple line is going to go, so the purple tie, that speaks to the work of Valerie and Montgomery County and Prince George's County, but also speaks to how much we understand the red line, which we all fought for, was important for us. And so this is a great day of bringing these all of us together. We're excited about, you know, the next 13 days. We're excited about taking on Larry Hogan. We're excited about changing Maryland. I do want to have this opportunity, since we do have our county executive here, to have County Executive Ike Leggett, who actually has worked with Valerie and myself, to say a few words.
Thank you, Rushern. I also had the opportunity to work with Kevin Kevinich over the years as well. And I think when you look at what we see today, he'll be proud of this ticket and what Ms. Johnson and Ms. Ervin have done today in terms of endorsing this team. We stand here in a community that I think is in transition. But just some months ago, a county executive and I stood right here to dedicate this particular crossing, this transit center. But more importantly, over the years, Valerie has fought for transit in this area, whether it's the Purple Line, whether it's the school. In addition to all the services she served on the county council, Valerie was actively involved as a member of the Montgomery County Board of Education as well. This is a great day for this team, a great day for Maryland. I am proud to see this endorsement, and I'm proud to see that we have people who are going to talk passionately about the issues going forward with the next 13 days to ensure that a win for the Baker-Emery ticket. That is what this is about today. But more importantly, it is about the continuation of my good friend Kevin Kevinich, Valerie Ervin, Rushern Baker, Ms. Emery, and all the others who worked for this ticket. We see that this is bringing together a unified force of people who are committed to progressive issues to ensure the betterment for the great state of Maryland. Thank you.
There's some questions.
The question was, did I ask to add anything to Mr. Baker's platform? I have not. I know Mr. Baker's platform very well, and it is in alignment with what Marisol Johnson and I have been fighting for. I'm going to be speaking out on his behalf these next 13 days to ensure that we win this primary. But of course, I have a passionate vision about some issues that maybe Mr. Baker might not embrace fully, but that's okay. It's the Democratic Party, so it's a big tent. I consider myself a progressive, and so does Marisol, and I believe that adding our names to the Baker-Embry ticket as their surrogates will bring out the kind of voters that got excited when Marisol and I got in this race.
Valerie, you said that the...
My response is, it's a lie, and that's all I can say about it. And it's been written about, and there's not much more to say about it. I think that the character that he is showing voters in Maryland is not the character of the next governor that I want to support.
Valerie, you said the outcome of the election could be vulnerable to contention based on your experience. What do you mean by that? Can you explain it for us?
Well, this particular ballot has been challenged in court three times. The first time was Nathaniel Oakes. It was challenged by a woman who was running against him in the district. That challenge went to the Maryland Court of Appeals. The challenge was mine and Marisol's next, because Marisol Johnson's name does not show up on the ballot at all. And we are legitimate candidates for governor, and were lieutenant governor. We challenged it in circuit court. We did not prevail. The third challenge came about a week ago. A voter from Maryland challenged the fact that Krish, and I'm not going to say her name because I pronounce it wrong, candidate for governor, is not a resident with the requisite requirements to be able to run for governor. And I'm saying all these three things because it's a ballot fraught with lots of problems. And as a progressive woman who's also always fought for voting rights, it raises questions which may have to be determined after the June 26th primary, but anybody with standing, I'll tell you who has standing in this, any voter in this, within the sound of my voice today in Maryland, can challenge the outcome of this election. Any of my opponents could challenge the outcome of this election, and if Marisol Johnson and I wanted to do so, we could also challenge the outcome of the election. I just think that unfortunately, the circumstances that we found ourselves in was because someone died, and the State Board of Elections had no contingency plan, nor did they follow the letter of the law.
Ms. Ervin, given all that, then, what do you say to some of those undecided voters out there? They're 39% by one survey, who say, Democrats can't get it together, I guess I will vote for Hogan.
I really can't respond to it that way, but I will say that now that Marisol and I have decided to team up with the Baker-Embry ticket, it's a much clearer choice, because people would have been very confused going into the booth to vote for Ervin Johnson. It's magic, because we don't exist. So we fought a valiant fight for 26 days, and I'm very proud of what Marisol and I were able to accomplish in such a short period of time. I feel like the victory is already ours, because we showed up on behalf of Kevin Kamenetz, and we moved forward on behalf of everyone who's going to vote in this election. So we feel like the victory has already been won, because we showed ourselves and we spoke about issues that no one else was talking about. And we brought fire where there was no fire, and we'll continue to bring the fire.
Yes, sir, yes, sir, but you're
covered. Some girls of color who say, oh, well, we can't get on the ballot, we can't succeed, we have to throw our weight behind a bail candidate.
Can I just say this? I have two, everyone knows I have two young adult daughters, and I didn't tell them about this press conference until it broke on the news, but they both were like, wow, we are so glad, because they loved the ticket. They loved Valerie and Marisol's ticket and the passion that they were bringing to this cause. And they said, Daddy, she's talking about the things that you were talking about and doing in Prince George's County. Minimum wage, we actually raised the minimum wage the largest in Montgomery County and Prince George's County. Seeing women of color actually out there and talking about these issues out front is important, So this partnership with Elizabeth and I is about actually continuing that work, not just for the next 13 days, but we're going to do it for the next, you know, 4.5 months after that, and then we're going to take it to the State House where we make these changes that they have brought to the forefront. So we feel good about this ticket and partnership. What I've said, and I have not, I don't want to speak for them, but what Elizabeth and I have done with people who support us, whether it's County Executive Ike Leggett, whether it's Chris Van Hollen, a U.S. Senator, or Brian Frost, the Attorney General, what we've said is that when you endorse us, it's not just for the election, it's to help us govern. And so I want, and I expect that Valerie's going to want this, and Marisol is going to want this, that we're going to work together in our administration to make life in Maryland better, to continue the work that they've done, not just as candidates, but they've done throughout their careers.
There's a question here that I want to respond to.
Uh-huh. What do you say to those who say that your withdrawal on the eve of early voting simply introduces more chaos into a process that you were already concerned about being chaotic?
I never said I was concerned about chaos. That was the circuit court judge who said, by adding Marisol and my name to the ballot, by putting stickers over candidates' name would create chaos. I never said anything about chaos. There will be no chaos. Voters will go in the booth and they will vote their conscience. And before Marisol and I decided to support the Baker Embry ticket, it was going to be very, very difficult for people to find us and be able to vote for us, which is why the ballot is a question.